Remnant is the core component in the FNAF narrative. Understanding it is the main motivation for the series' antagonist William Afton, who attempts to recreate the same incident which caused his discovery of the substance. So, what is it? That's what I will be explaining in this video.
You know, for something that's so important for the series, it's something I don't see covered a lot, especially on YouTube, so I want to change that. By the way, I want this video to be as objective as possible, as this is not a theory video, but one designed to be a guide for those who don't know what Remnant is confused by the concept, or for newcomers to the franchise. So if I get anything wrong in this video, let me know and supply proof if possible. Anyway, let's get into it.
Remnant is the substance used to describe paranormal occurrences and behaviors in FNAF. Remnant is the spark for life beyond death. It's the reason why spirits or memories of who a person once was continues to live while reborn into our realm. But how does this work? The key to this is emotion. Well, rather intense emotion. The most powerful of all, with the most extensive radius, is agony. The prime example of spirits being tethered to this world is the MCI, the Missing Children's Incident Kids. William Afton lured 5 kids to the safe room of a Freddy Fazbear's pizzeria and murdered them there, stuffing their bodies into the suits of the animatronic mascots Freddy, Bonnie, Chica, Foxy, and Golden Freddy / Redbear, giving them newfound life in the animatronics. With the agony, fear, pain, and anger radiating in the room, the souls and the memories of the children imprinted themselves onto the robots, creating a form of sentient life for them. For this to work, however, the bodies of the children had to be stuffed into the suits because the spirit follows the flesh, it would seem, and also the pain. That's basically it. Remnant is the bounding of something that once was a soul or memories of who someone was, making them almost real again, as Dr. Talbot says in Fazbear Frights Epilogue 11. Remnant is, in non-scientific terms, it's like the metal is haunted. It's more complicated than that, of course, but it's similar to the way that water conducts electricity. Remnant is the mixing of the tangible with the intangible, of memory with the present. The people and things that are lost, it makes them almost real again. The best conductor for Remnant is metal, which makes the animatronics perfect vessels for souls and or memories, otherwise known as possession. Are souls the only means to creating life in FNAF? Well, no. You see, memories also play a huge factor with a Remnant. Memories and emotion are embedded in blood, sweat, and tears of a person, and if an object is drenched enough in it, then it can create life. An example of this taking effect is in The Fourth Closet. After the loss of his daughter, Charlie, Henry Emberley, co-founder of Fazbear Entertainment, started to go a little insane. The last thing he had of his daughter was a doll named Ella. For months, he wept all over the doll and started believing the doll was actually his daughter. Though he wasn't content with that, he decided to rebuild his daughter at various stages of her life. The first, a toddler. The second, a child. The third, a teenager. And the fourth, a young woman. He stopped after the fourth. Why? Well, he realized how far off the deep end he fell. Henry fabricated memories of Charlie's life with a tripod camera, programmed her, fitted her with illusion discs to maintain the illusion that Charlie was alive, and with the Elador embedded with Henry's grief, memories, and illusions, Charlie was given new life. The rebuilt Charlie's did not have her soul inside of her, but the agony of a grieving father in a doll which was planted inside each robot. This is what gave them life. With fabricated memories and an AI built into them is what gave them a form of sentience. There are a few extra points I want to share in this video about the Charlie bots, but instead of talking about them, I'll have a few points on screen for them. So you can pause the video if you want to understand more about each of them. Another example of this happening is instead in the games. The FNAF 4 crying child, no he doesn't have a name, wept all week long, and with his big brother tormenting him, it didn't help. The crying child, on the day of his death, was shoved into the mouth of the Fredbear animatronic by his brother and bullies. It was all just supposed to be a little fun, but what they didn't know was about to happen was Fredbear's mouth crushed the child's skull, leading to his eventual death in the hospital. Crying Child was able to find new life in the Fredbear animatronic via his tears and blood soaked into the mouth of the animatronic. Can early memories be embedded in an animatronic or object be Remnant? Yes, actually. As Dr. Talbot says, Remnant is the mixing of the tangible with the intangible, of memory with the present. The people and the things that are lost, it makes them almost real again. The memory of someone embedded into an inanimate object is basically what Remnant is. Remnant doesn't necessitate a soul to be bound to the object, but more so the memories of a person born from agony or an emotion with equivalent intensity to agony imprinted onto something. To sum up, remnant is the combining or imprinting of one's own soul and or memories of who a person once was onto an object, but more so metal, because metal is the best conductor for emotions. With the power of agony or an intense emotion equivalent to agony, a soul or memories of who a person once was can be tethered or imprinted to something to give it life. Again, typically something made of metal in FNAF because it's the best conductor of emotional energies. Can emotion on its own be remnant? Well, no, because it's the emotional energies which bounds a spirit and implants memories of a person into an object. The only difference is that remnant contains memories or a soul of a person bound by an emotion, whilst agony is just the raw emotion. Agony itself can animate objects, but it can't give it sentient life. For example, the mimic from the Tales from the Pizzaplex epilogues. The mimic is an animatronic designed to mimic the behavior of people and things it saw and learned from it. Edwin, after the loss of his son David, smashed the endo with his murderous rage. After that, it began to mimic what it witnessed. Yes, the mimic is infused with Edwin's agony, but it only gave it paranormal properties such as flickering lights. It can also cause hallucinations, which explains what the FNAF 3 phantom animatronics are. They're the byproduct of agony radiating from the agony-infused objects and springtrap in the building. However, agony can also manifest itself into physical being. An example of this is the shadow animatronics. Freddy, Bonnie, or his canon name, RXQ, and the other random shadow creatures in the FNAF 3 minigames. Can Remnant be destroyed? No, at least not from what we've seen. Remnant cannot be destroyed. There was a hypothesis that Remnant can be destroyed in fire, which is why the FNAF 3 and 6 locations were burned. On the blueprints for the scooper, a machine designed to collect remnant from an animatronic and injector. On these blueprints, it stated that, when heated, no observable motion. Keep a heated tank at sustained temperature. Substance should be malleable, but not more. There is a possibility that overheating might neutralize the effects permanently. As this was just a theory, it was revealed that the remnant does not in fact burn in fire, which means that the remnant of the MCI, the spirit which resides in Molten Freddy at the time of FNAF 6, is intact. The result of the fire may have been showcased to us in Security Breach in the form of the Blob. Yeah, the Blob. Very creative name, I know, but apparently in the character encyclopedia, it's not its canon name, which is unknown as of this video. So how are the spirits set free then? We can help the spirits find their way and take the steps towards their afterlife, but they can only be set free if they are content to do so. We can help them by either helping them remember who they are or help them find their happiest day, a happy memory from their past or a dream which will drag them away from their agony and body, giving them peace. Jake began to feel as though he was being sucked out of the thing he was in. He felt like he was a puff of smoke and he was being borne by an air current away from the being that had contained him. He could feel himself being pulled into the memory itself. He intuitively understood that if he was enveloped in the memory, he could stay in that happy place forever. But does that mean that they are set free? Well, this is going to be subjective, but I don't think so. As stated before, spirits can only leave if they are content to do so. An example of this is with the MCI. They can only move on if their killer rests, William Afton. While he is around, they won't be content to do so. Charlie, William's first victim and protector of the MCI, won't be content to move on so long as Afton and the spirits are still here. Basically, remnant can only be dissipated if the emotion like agony of a tragedy remains, keeping the spirits and the memories of who they were to this world is healed and they are set free. As Henry said in the FNAF 6 fire,
"This place will not be remembered, and the memory of everything that started this can finally begin to fade away, as the agony of every tragedy should."
Something I want to cover relatively quickly is soul splitting. Basically, it's when haunted metal is melted to a state where it's malleable and injected into other bodies such as animatronics. The souls in the metal spread around into the other animatronics and parts of their souls are spread across multiple bodies simultaneously. We see this in the fourth closet where Afton melts down the FNAF 1 endos and injects their remnant into the Funtime animatronics to experiment to see how much control he can have over them and move his soul into his own metal body made from the spirit's metal so he can live forever. Going off tangent, but this is only possible if the spirits consent to keeping you alive. Why would the spirits want to keep Afton alive? Well, conveniently, when Afton injected the spirit's remnants into the other animatronics, splitting their souls, and with spirit's tendencies to forget, the spirits only see Afton as the friendly mascot that lured them to the back room before he took their lives. Anyway, this is one way soul splitting can work. Another way is having the parts of the possessed animatronic parts and suits scattered around various places as seen with the Fun Times and Sister location in the FNAF 3 End of Night minigames. One last way for soul splitting to work is infection. In Phasma Frights, Andrew's anger infected various objects, resulting in his agony corrupting them with parts of his soul/memories. We got to this big place with lots of cool stuff. All I can remember after that is wanting to be everywhere. I can remember being all over the place in all kinds of things. Does Remnant have any other properties? Yes, actually. Remnant can also heal your body as described in Tales from the Pitaplex number 1, Story Frailty, where the girl named Jessica works in a hospital and scrapes bits of remnant off of her heart pendant to patients and it actually heals them. This is also why Michael Afton was able to stand up after Annette vacated his body. His skeleton was able to grow back and presumably the rest of his body because as Abby, aka Elizabeth Afton, said to him,
"You won't die."
Remnant can also bring people back from the dead, also shown in Frailty. And lastly, Remnant is also the key to immortality, which is one of William Afton's main motives for his experimentation. All of these properties only take effect if the spirit residing with their remnant consents to it by giving the person it's injected to a piece of them, aka part of their memories. They have to want to save you or keep you alive. To sum it up, Remnant is basically intense emotion like agony, keeping a spirit or memory of who someone was tethered to this world. It can't be destroyed, and the only way it can be dissipated is if the agony of a tragedy has been healed and the spirits have their happiest day, moving on to the afterlife. Soul splitting can be the result of remnants being injected into new vessels. Haunted objects with the same soul in them can be located in various places at the same time, and emotional energies can inject objects causing their soul/memories to be split into them. Remnant can heal a person, bringing them back from the dead and grant immortality so long as the spirit allows you to live. Well, I hope that explained Remnant accurately and you aren't too confused by it. If you have any questions, you can ask down in the comments. I'll try my best to answer as many as I can to the best of my ability. Again, as stated at the beginning of the video, if I'm wrong about Remnant, please let me know because I would like to keep this video as objective as possible with the knowledge that we have at current time. Also, if there's anything else which should warrant inclusion, I'll add it in a pinned comment. Thank you for watching and I hope you enjoyed your day/evening.